We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello students, today we are going to implement a VB.NET practical using which you can perform insert, update and delete operation in VB.NET. So let us start. First of all, you need to create a GUI form like this. Okay, so I will take you to the new project. You need to select Visual Basic, and in that you need to select Windows Form Application. Write down an appropriate name. And select OK. Okay, so now you can see that we have created a new project. First of all, you need to change the, you need to arrange the properties of the controls in A to Z format. For that, you need to click over here, alphabetical, and then write down the name of the form. We are creating an application for bounded control. Okay, fine. Now we are going to change the background color of the form. That you can do with the help of background color. Fine. Now let us try to implement the GUI described as earlier. Okay, so now first of all, let us try to bind our database with our application. Okay, so for that, what you need to do, first of all, you need to go to the Server Explorer, right, and click on add connection. But before that, remember that over here we are trying to connect Microsoft Access database with our controls. So make sure that your database is available in the application in which you are going to bind the controls. Okay, so first of all, let's say my database is available in here, right? Student. So I'm copying that. I'm putting it to my project folder. Okay. So now you can see the database is available in student bound control project called student.mdb. Now what you have to do? You need to check whether the fields and tables are available or it is visible to me in tables or not. So here you can see the table called student is available. Right click on that and retrieve the data. Now you can see I have inserted few records in it, right? Now what we need to do, first of all, we need to copy the connection string from the property of the active connection. So for that, you need to right click on your database, go to properties and connection string. Over here you can see the entire path for the connection string. Okay, that you need to copy first of all. Okay, now go to the toolbox, find out data grid view control. Okay, here you can see the data grid view control is available. Okay, now select auto size column mode to all cells and auto size row mode to all cells, which will automatically arrange the content of the table within the displayed area. Fine. Then you can go for scroll bars. You can see over here both the scroll bars are available. Now we are going to bind this data grid view control with our database. So for that, you need to click on this smart tag button. Then select the data source. As you can see right now, this data grid view control is not at all bound to any control, so it shows me none. What I have to do? I have to click on add project data source. Then select the database. Next, create a new data set. Now you can see one connection is available. You can see the same connection string over here. Fine. You can copy that. Okay, next. Now this connection string will be added to app.config file, which is not at all required to know about it right now. Click on next. Now you can see the tables. In that table, student table is there. Select all the attributes which you would like to display in the data grid view control or which you would like to bind with the controls available on the form, right? So click on finish button. Now you can see this data grid view control has been bounded with our database. Is it clear? Let's check it out whether it is bounded or not. You can see the data is available in this data grid view control and the data is automatically arranged within the size of data grid view control. Right? So this is the first step to bind our data grid view control. Okay, now you can see that we have prepared our layout as per the requirement. Now I'm going to bind the controls with this data bound tool. Okay, so let us start binding these controls with our database. So first of all, I'm binding my name text box. So for that, you need to select the name control. Go to data binding in the property. Click on text, write down. Over here now you can see student binding source is available. From where it came? It came from the data binding procedure of this data grid view control, right? You can see three more components have been added to our form, right? Now this is the main, which contains the connectivity to our database. So for binding these controls with our binding source, what we need to do, we need to click on data binding. First of all, we need to select the control which is to be bound, then go to its property, data binding. In data binding, we need to click on text, select the student binding source and select an appropriate field to be bound with the control. So over here, I would like to bind the name attribute with the text box. So I'm selecting name. Next one, same way. Go to text property, select an appropriate field, enrollment number, combo box is there, click on text, select branch. Okay, so let us check whether these controls have been bounded with it. Okay, yes, now you can see when I change the selection from the data grid view, the data will get changed accordingly in the bounded control. Okay, so up till now we have seen how you can bind your Access database with a data grid view control and with the another tools available, right? With the other controls available on the form. Now we are going to see how you can perform add, update, delete and search operation in our next session, right? Okay, so now we are going to perform the insert operation in our Access database. For that, first of all, I'm going to create a toggle button for inserting a new record. See, when I click on the new button, it should clear all the text boxes, or you can say the controls available on the form in which I have to provide the data, right? And as soon as I click on the new button, the caption of this button will get changed to insert. Okay, so first of all, I'm creating a toggle button. For that, if btn new dot text is equals to new, then we have to change its caption to insert, right? Else it should be changed to new. Okay, so let us see whether it is working or not. Now you can see it is working as a toggle button. Now we are going to implement the functionality. Okay, now we have to insert something in the database. So for that, we need to take help of data adapter controller. As you know, data adapter acts as a bridge between the front end and back end. So first of all, we need to allow our controls to add, insert and update, right? For that, what you need to do, we need to check whether this control is having the ability to add, insert and delete operation or not. So for that, you need to make sure that this checkbox has been selected, okay? Or you can say check, right? Now you can see one data set, student data set dot xsd file is there, in which we are going to create a new method. For creating a new method, you can right click on this and add query. Okay, you can see use SQL statement. So which operation we are going to perform? We are going to perform insert operation. So select on insert, click next. This is what my query is, insert into student. Then the name of columns, values and the question marks are there. I would like to insert 4 attributes in my table. So 4 question marks are there. Okay, so now you may have question that from where we get the data for this question mark. You can have this data of this question mark from the next button. Over here you can see we have generated insert statement, finish. Now you can see insert query is there. It is available in student data set. Okay, so I can insert a data in this data set, in this database, using the insert query command, right? So once again, move back to our design view. First of all, what I have to do? Student binding source dot add new. Now you can see what is the use of add new. It will create an empty record in our existing data set. That is what we require, right? Next, when it should create an empty record, as soon as I click on new button, it should clear all the controls available on the form, right? So this is what the use of this add new button. Similarly, as soon as I click on new button, the caption of that button will get changed to the insert. It means now we are ready to provide data in our controls. Okay, now when the caption of the button is insert, and if I click on that button, then it will move to the else part. And when it moves to the else part, what needs to be happen? The data, whatever we have inserted in the control, they needs to be inserted into the database. And for that, we need to take help of what? Data adapter control, because it acts as a bridge between front end and back end. So name of my data adapter is student table adapter. So I will write student table adapter dot. As you can see, we have created this query, insert query, in a data set over here, right? Which contains how many parameters? 4 parameters: name, address, enrollment number, and branch, right? So I'm writing insert query. As soon as I write opening bracket, you can see few arguments are required: name, address, enrollment number, and branch. These arguments will be available to us from the controls. So I will write txt name dot text comma which is the next argument, that is address. Txt address dot text next er, sorry, txt er number dot text comma. For branch I have used combo box, so it will be cmd branch dot text. Okay, so it will insert the records, or you can say the data available in these controls, directly into the database. But we need to finally update our data set back to the database. So for that I will use student data set dot accept changes. Okay, so it will load finally updated data back to our database. Now what else we want? We want to see the data to whatever we have recently inserted, that needs to be updated in our data grid control. So for that I need to copy the same line and paste it over here. Okay, so now our code for the insertion of record is ready. Now let us see whether it is working or not. As you can see, the first record has been available in the bound control. Now I am clicking on new button. Let's say the name of student is Mehta Jack Baruch. Enrollment number 18660307042. And the branch name, see, you can see I haven't loaded any branch over here, so I can write down computer. Right? Now you can see that caption of this button has been changed from new to insert, and one new empty record has been inserted. As soon as I click on insert button, that record will get updated in my data set. Now you can see the data is available. MathTajack. Okay. Now let us see whether this data is stored in our database or not. Okay. So for that I need to terminate the execution. Then I will select. I will go for my database. Here is my database. Now let us check whether the data has been inserted in database or not. Okay, you have seen whenever I perform the insert operation, the record is not yet inserted into my database, though it can be seen over here in my data set. It means whatever data, updated data, is available in my data set, that is not reflected back to my database. For that, what we need to do, we need to click on project, right click on project folder, open folder in file explorer, right? Then you need to locate to the database. See, my database is available in my project folder, so I will copy this path and paste it into app.config file. As you can see, I have already pasted it out. Previously it was only the database name, but I have changed it to the complete path, absolute path you can say, right? Now again I am performing the same operation. Click on start button, click on new, right? Let's say Ruch. I'm providing the static data because I have not yet loaded my combo box control. Now I'm clicking on insert button. As you can see, the data has been stored and displayed in the data grid view control. Yes, it is there. Now we are checking whether it is actually being stored in my database or not. So for that, again, I will go to my database student. Now you can see the data has been reflected back to my database, right? So now it is clear what changes we need to make. We need to provide over here the entire physical path. Okay, now similarly we are going to perform the update operation. For that, again I have to create one more method called insert. So I will click on adapter, add query, SQL statement. Which operation? Update operation we need to perform. Then next, update query. Any name you can provide over here, but I am keeping it as update query. Instead of that, you can say update student, let's say. So update student, generated update statement, finish, right? We forget to provide the parameter query builder. Update student set. Okay, over here we need to write down the SQL statement for the update. Update student set name is equals to question mark, comma, address is equals to question mark, comma, branch is equals to question mark, where er underscore number is equals to question mark. See, over here we are considering that our enrollment number is a primary key, so we are not going to change our enrollment number. You need to make sure that at the time of making a new entry, or you can say perform the update operation, you are not supposed to change enrollment number. Okay, so my query will look like this: update table name set attribute name, value will be available to us from the controls, and we are considering our enrollment number as a primary key. So we are not supposed to change it at the time of update operation. Next, the name of this method is update student. Save it, store. Now you can see the similar parameters. Save it. Get back to your update button. Once again, we need to create a toggle button over here. So first of all, let us create a toggle button. See, I have not changed the name of the control. So first of all, I am changing the name of control. It should be BTN update. And at the same time, we have not loaded this combo box. So I am loading this combo box. Okay, so we have loaded our combo box control with the branch names. Now we are going to create a toggle button for update. So for that, again, what I have to write down, if btn update dot text is equals to update. If it is update, then we need to change it to save. Should be save. Else it should be update. Fine. So this is what we have performed, the toggle button, as we have implemented in case of new button, right? Again, now we are not supposed to provide anything over here. But instead of that, what we need to do? We need to simply change the button. Okay, fine. Now it's time to call the method the way we have called in case of insert student table adapter dot update. student, right? In which we need to pass the parameter. Now you can see over here how many parameters they are asking, 1, 2, and 3, and the fourth parameter will be considered as original. It means you are not supposed to change this parameter. If we change this parameter in the text box, then we should not get the updated data because that record is not available, because it will be enrollment number is considered as a primary key. So we are not supposed to change this attribute at the time of updation. So again, I'm writing the same thing, txt name dot text, txt address dot text. Then the third parameter is branch cmd, branch dot text, and the fourth parameter through which you can change the data, that is enrollment number, txt enrollment number dot text. Okay, fine. Now whatever changes we had done, that needs to be updated to my database, and okay, so we have implemented the update command. Let us check whether it is working or not. Let's say we are updating this record, right? So first of all, I need to select the record, Paresh Patel, sorry. We need to click on update button. Update, you can say the caption has been changed. Now we'll update the record and save it. Now you can see the record has been updated in data grid view, but we need to make sure that the changes has been reflected back to the database. So for that, we'll check it through the database. You can see the record has been updated. Fine. Okay. Now we'll create the third operation, that is delete operation. For that, what we have to do? We have to again create one method. For that, right click on student adapter, add query, select SQL statement. We would like to perform update operation. So select update. Sorry. We would like to create a delete operation. So it should be delete. Delete from student where ER number is equals to question mark. Over here again, we are considering our enrollment number as a primary key, so it should be a unique. Otherwise, it can remove more than one record if we are having multiple entries for the same enrollment number. Again, we are changing the name of this command to delete student. So delete command has been generated. You can see one parameter it is asking, that is enrollment number, through which it will remove the record, right? So student table adapter dot delete student, what it is asking? It is asking the enrollment number. So from where I can get the enrollment number? Txt er number dot text. Okay, student data set dot accept changes. And again, what we need to do, that data should be reflected back to my data grid view control. Okay, that's it. Let us check whether delete command is working or not. Okay, let's say first of all we are creating a new record. Manoj Parmar. I'm sorry. The branch is electrical, let's say. Insert. See, the record has been updated. Fine. Let us see. It is there. Manoj Parmar is there. Now we'll remove MetaJet from the database. See, you might have seen that the record has been removed from the database, but it is not reflected back to my data grid view control, and that happens because we have not updated our data grid view control. So let us update it. Same thing we need to perform in case of update operation. Okay, now let us see whether it can remove record or not. Let's say Manoj Parmar. As you can see, Manoj Parmar has been removed from the database. Yes. Now we are going to implement the search functionality. First of all, you need to remember to which parameter you would like to search the record. So let us start with the search. For that, we need to implement one more method through which we can find the record. Once again, right click on student table adapter, click on add query, SQL, select which returns rows, next, select star from student where ER underscore number is equals to, see, we are going to use wildcard character. I would like to find a particular record through the part of an enrollment number. So I'm using single quote plus question mark plus single quote. Over here I have to write down percentage. So it will find the data in between the enrollment number field. Where enrollment number is equal to this. Okay, next. Finish. Let us change the name filter. Filter underscore student. Okay. So let us filter it in the text change event of this text box. Student table adapter dot filter student is asking me for the enrollment number, so that will be in txt search dot text. Now let us check whether it can find the record or not. So now you can see over here I have three records from each department: 07 for computer, 06 for civil, and 09 for electrical. Let us find out 07 first of all. Text change event is not working. Okay, we need to remove it. We need to add one more query. Select star from student where er underscore number like single quote percentage plus question mark plus next fill by next finish. So over here you can see fill by method is there. Initially we have forgotten to write like clause, So we are not getting the desired result. Now here, the exchange event, student table adapter dot enrollment number txt search dot text. Okay, instead of writing the get fill method, we need to call fill by method, because ultimately it returns me the record true, right? So what I have to write down, student table adapter dot fill by, once again I'm writing dot, see we have this also, but we need to call fill by, in which it is asking for the two parameters. The first one is data table and the second one is enrollment number through which we are finding the record. Okay, so it is data set, student data set rather, student data set dot student, the name of the table, comma txt search dot text. Okay, now let's say if I would like to implement something like this, that whenever the text box is empty, it should display me all the records, right? And whenever something is written, it should filter the data accordingly. So in that case, we need to provide one more condition. If txt search dot text is equals to blank, then it should fill this record. It should display me all the records, and when it is not empty, it should display me the filtered record. Now let us check. Okay, now you can see it shows me all the record because the field is empty, control is empty. Let's say we are writing 09, so it will display me only the data whose enrollment number contains the 09 as a part of a string. If I write 04, now you can see there is no enrollment number containing 04 in it. And if it is empty, then it will show me all the records. So that's it from my side. Thank you.